Hey besties, I'm gonna teach y'all how to play Winboys, the raising game where you're a high school band director. So I'm in the Japanese app store right now, and I linked the video that I used to get everything started in the description. I don't know how to do it on Android, so my apologies. But if you just search Winboys, like in English, then the app will pop up. It'll look like that. So go ahead and download it and open it. And this is what the title screen looks like before you clear chapter 5 of the main story. This is like terms of service privacy policy. Press the blue button to accept. That's the loading screen with a chibi and a fun fact. Sometimes it could take like 10 seconds, so I'm editing the rest out. This is the prologue of the main story, and everything from the prologue through chapter 5, I believe, is fully voiced. So I linked a fan translation in the description, so please enjoy. It's nice, wholesome, pretty realistic, and you'll really enjoy it if you're any form of band geek, past, present, future. I'm going to skip. This is the opening movie, which I will also skip, but again, please enjoy. This is the initial download of all the game's data. It's pretty chonky at 2 GB. It takes approximately 20 minutes, so I highly encourage you to just set your device down and do something else. You can also take this opportunity to take a quick look at people's profiles. So I'll just quickly introduce everyone by the year and instrument. Minato, first year trumpet. Takara, first year tuba. Soshu, first year flute. Ose, first year trombone. Hibiku, first year clarinet. Seria, third year tuba. Sogaku, second year percussion. Atsukage, third year clarinet. Tsugumi, third year percussion. Mitsuyuki, second year euphonium. Reito, second year alto sax. Ijong, second year French horn. Toki, second year trombone. Ikumi, second year flute. Yasuhito, first year alto sax. Junta, second year trumpet. Yotaro, third year berry sax. Izuru, first year tenor sax. Akane, second year trombone. Daisuke, second year French horn. Kojiro, first year French horn. Alto, first year bass clarinet. Yahiko, third year flute. Mashu, first year percussion. Mikio, second year clarinet. And lastly, Kuri, first year trumpet. Okay, finished loading. You can choose between doing the story or the gacha first. We're gonna go with the story. I skipped ahead. This ikemen is your coworker Ushio. You reveal your gender to him. Unfortunately, you can only decide between female or male, but you can change it any time and it doesn't affect the story at all. So I'll just go with male. And this is where you set your username and your nickname. I'll just be Windbro. Uncheck the box if you want your nickname to be different from your username. I will be Landon, as in Landon these nuts. And lastly, you set your birthday. I set mine as the next day of this recording so you can see what it looks like. So confirm everything with a blue button and you can go ahead and skip the rest of the story. So we're gonna get into the gameplay, which is a bunch of band activities. You're in the classroom with your starting five. It uses up 10 stamina. The psychology of how everyone holds their bag. So everything that they do is completely random every time, which is very addicting. And it's especially satisfying if you have a range of different instruments, like a mix of woodwind, brass, and also percussion. And if you're wondering why blue-haired dude is just standing there staring at people, it's because he didn't join the band yet. So all this practice leads up to a mini rehearsal at the end. So at the end of each of these extracurricular activities, your team gains a little bit of level, bond, and your rank goes up a little. You actually start out with 2 free SSRs, the highest rarity card. This is the scouting screen. Eventually, you will become very familiar with everyone's silhouette. And the different colors stand for different rarities. So rainbow is SSR, gold is SR, silver is R. There can be flips. So if you see, for example, a blue, then that also turns into an SSR, and sometimes they can just randomly turn into an SSR. These cards can only be initial cards. All the initial cards are voiced. It is possible to get two of the same person. So if you press the orange button, you can reroll however many times you want. Initial cards will always be in the gacha pool, so I wouldn't worry too much. I just rerolled until I got Izuru and Minato because I like the way they take selfies. You get two more SSRs of your choice after this. So you get your next SSR through beginner missions. I'll explain everything as we go. So you're gonna jump immediately to whatever login bonuses happened that day. I timed it so you're gonna see what someone's birthday looks like. It happens to be this funky guy, Toki's birthday. I have no idea who was on that cake. And this year they're wearing these goofy ass hats, so... And the cool part is that in the beginning you get a whopping 500 notes every day for a week. And with every new scout, there's an opening little mini-movie. This is what the card looks like idolized. Oh, he's playing darts. Mal Future Scout 2, who? And that's where the news shows up. It takes a while to load, so I just close it. So that's your present box. I just collect everything as I go along. And those are your missions. I also, anytime I see like the notification that something's there, I just claim right away. Just a good habit to have. So if you noticed, we got a birthday cake. That's specifically for Toki's birthday. Feeding the boys food increases their bond, and the birthday cake is an item that gives probably like the most points. So I call it making my offering, just feed him the cake. There are voiced lines through, I think, up to bond level 8. But the maximum bond for now, I believe, is 12 or 14. So yeah, anytime you get food, just know that it's for increasing the bond. Right away, you can straight up just choose another SSR. I'm just gonna go with Toki, the birthday boy, since he is the last attribute that I need. If you don't care about which characters you get in the beginning, I recommend to have at least an SSR of each attribute. So there are three attributes, visually pink, green, blue. You'll just have an easier time starting out. You get a signature with every SSR. Okay, so anyway, here are the beginning missions. Pressing the button takes you right where you need to go, so that's really convenient. This first one is you set your location, and it's cool if you live in Japan because the weather outside the window of your home screen will match whatever region you choose. So I just picked a random place. I'll just press buttons. Next, you're gonna change the description on your profile. My longest Winboys ever. Just like my longest yeah boy ever. Next, you're gonna make your board. This is really cute because you can treat it like an Ida bag, but since you're like the teacher, this is what like teachers do. You get more stuff through the special shop and also increasing your bond and getting more cards. You can see anyone's random board who's online and the boards of your friends. So you can freestyle it or you can choose through templates. And we're just gonna go with templates for now, just so it's nice and easy. There's 5 different types to choose from. I'm just gonna put in the first 2 cards that I got. And hit the blue button to confirm. Next, you're gonna change who's on your home screen. I chose Toki the birthday boy. The sound mixing is kind of off. I feel like the music can be too loud, so I'm just gonna adjust the settings, whatever works for me. Turn the music down. Turn that voice up. And the sound effects can be... Maybe it's good where it is.
勉強? 別にそんなしてねえけど、授業を聞いてりゃどうにかなんじゃね?
That's much better for me. Next, you're gonna set a password for your account. Put it top and bottom and confirm with the blue button. So these last three missions require you to go through the main story and its stages. And real quick, this book icon is where all the stories are. There's a really useful filter, which I use all the time. Every story you read, you get notes, so make sure to go through those over time. So we're gonna continue with chapter one of the main story. These little icons are little campaigns going on. There's more notes. You could get more of Toki's little power-up thingies. I'm gonna skip through the main story for the length of video, so this video won't be a million years. Okay, so we're gonna do some more band activities. And outside of events, this is how you farm more materials in rank and bond. These bars show progress towards unlocking these one-liners that give you notes when you read them. And there are three attributes per stage, just as there are three attributes per card. You can get bonus points depending on bond between different characters. And it'll be shown there, if you have any. Really important before you start any new stage, just auto-set your team to whatever strongest cards the game thinks. And I always use a multiplier for my stamina to save time. Again, 450 notes if you can S clear. If you play stages of characters with a speech bubble whose bars aren't filled, you make progress. I think this achievement was for like unlocking or reaching fever, but I'll show you what it looks like in the next round. So I'm just gonna choose this stage because there's two people with a speech bubble. This is kind of like to configure how your team like auto forms, but I don't know. I didn't change anything. So again, auto form your team. I'm checking my multiplier. I have 20 stamina, so I'll spend 20. Okay, so fever, you get more items, and there's a rock remix to the music that's usually playing. Okay, so another achievement was to reach rank 3. And actually, I'm going to just clear as many stages as I can. At the very end, there's a performance, and that's where your SP comes into play. So with these SP stages, again, auto-form your team, and I don't do a S clear, so I won't get the maximum amount of notes, but I'm just gonna do it right now, just to show what it looks like. Yeah, they're playing Pomp and Circumstance. So usually, it'll either be the featured characters in the story or the cards that you currently have that'll have the little cut-ins. Okay, so I cleared the first chapter. And every time you finish a chapter, you get little progress on a scrapbook of memories. And you could revisit it through that little tiny button in the stories tab. So we cleared all the beginning missions. And there's a cute little board from the first years. Look, it has their instruments so you know it's them. So press the blue button to claim your fourth and last SSR. I'm gonna go with Yahiko. If you ever use him on your teams, he does not bring a bag to school. I think that's pretty iconic of him. Anyway, I'm gonna show you how to power up your cards so we can get the S clear for a maximum amount of notes. You power up with those lesson books, and there are like these skill trees to further max out your stats for a specific card and for a specific character. You'll need a lot of dupes to limit break, and you could limit break up to, I think, 4 times. So I'm showing me leveling up my card to level 10, but I couldn't get the S clear until level 20. If you have a card that matches the attribute of the final stage, for example, this one is pink, I would prioritize doing their skill tree. But it shouldn't be too hard to clear. So there we go, I used up all the SP, and I got the S clear. So once you S-clear every stage, you get the last page of that chapter. And I would just recommend keep going back until you fill out everyone's bar, so you get the maximum amount of notes for each chapter. Another reason why you'd want your cards at level 20 is because you get notes for reading their little side story. And here is the extra page that we unlocked at the end. So on the birthday that you set, you get this adorable, like, chalkboard art. And you're greeted by either your profile or your home screen, I don't know which one. But you also get 350 notes, which is really nice. Thank you. And it's also the day before a new event. So I just showed you how to go through the tutorial. And now I'm going to show you that it's actually possible from an account that's just starting out to get the event SSR. Sogaku. The event SR Daisuke. Now this is the Gacha. The Gacha SSR will be Junta. The Gacha SR will be Toki. And the Gacha R will be Ijong. If you plan on really going hard for an event, you should pull in the event gacha because you get bonus points. You access the event through this little button, and the day before an event, you get a little synopsis. And here's a peek at the gacha screen. So this is the event gacha. And to spark, you need 35,000 notes, which is not bad because you only need 10 pulls. And you can flip through the bloomed and unbloomed art. If they're wearing different clothes, then it'll show on the chibi, but not this time. Here's what the login screen looks like. The little coffee dessert restores SP, which is really important, and the ice creams restore stamina. You get 12 days for an event, so they give you a little leeway. So there's only one type of event, and it functions pretty similar to how you would go through the main story. Yeah, so you don't have to get the event gacha cards because you can just use your strongest cards of each of the gacha characters, which is cool. I skipped the story, and every time you clear a stage with stamina, you get these little tickets for each attribute. We're just gonna start here, and it's cool because the auto team knows which attribute you're going for. So I have 20 stamina, I used it. That's clear, so I got the maximum 450 notes. And you'll need those tickets to level up your performances that use SP. So I recommend just use all of the stamina items right away. The ones with the highlight are time limited, so definitely just use those for events. And as you get more event points, you unlock these mini dialogues from all the characters. Okay, so there goes the event SSR. Okay, so I'm gonna use 30 stamina. So I'm just gonna go through all these stages. And honestly, I just keep checking if I have any stamina refilling items. Okay, so 79 stamina, so I'll use 70 stamina on this stage. It's nice in the beginning because you'll keep ranking up, meaning you'll keep getting more stamina and more SP to use towards the event. Okay, so there goes Junta, the Gacha SSR. There's Daisuke, the event SR. And again, I have 40 stamina. Let me check. Okay, now it becomes 90 stamina. Make sure I auto-team. I didn't S-clear, but I'll go back to it later. So here's the Gacha SR Toki. Alright. So, I'm just gonna power up my cards real quick. And again, prioritize whichever attribute you need for that specific stage. In this case, I prioritized Toki's skill tree, but after that I checked if any other card could be powered up, and I just went ahead and used all my resources there. Prioritize powering up the SSRs that you got from the beginning, okay? This is the weekly mission. One thing that you need to make sure that you do is you need to visit someone's board. So I'm just gonna visit a random person's board. And you don't have to like it. Oh, we got a Sugumi lover. You don't have to like it, but I like it out of courtesy. We got an Osei lover over here. And we got a Junta lover over here. Nice, nice. And I will just unlock my current board, so if people want, they'll like my board back. It happens more often than you think. People are really nice. So there you go, 350 every week. If you just use up your stamina and your SP, that's like usually the missions. Oh my god, someone actually liked my board. I think it was a courtesy like back. Yeah, from the Junta lover. Thank you. Okay, so after doing enough of the stamina stages, I unlocked the Gacha R line, which is the last one, and we unlocked the final performance. So you'll need the level to be maxed to get the max amount of event points. So make sure that you auto-team. I'm not gonna do this yet because it's still at level 1. So we're gonna use all the tickets that we accumulated through doing the stages with stamina. But first, I'm going to make sure that I auto-form my team across all the attributes. Oh my god, look at that. Okay, and now I'm gonna compare which one gives me the most points. Just go straight for 10 SP because it takes a lot of SP to max it out. So it looks like the pink is the one that I'll do for now. In this, I just call it rehearsal. They play the event exclusive song. And as you can see, this event is kind of special because it has a new Japanese drum instrument. Look at Sogaku go. And you get to see the event characters in their costume. So, gonna use 10 more SP. And after that, we're gonna use even more SP. It's really nice because you can go straight- oh my god, wait. I ran out of tickets. Okay, now we'll use the one that gives the second most amount of tickets, which looks to be the green. Okay, let's go. Okay, so just keep pressing the blue button at the end until it's at max. Oh, okay, there we go. And I always use the SP recovering items. Okay, so now that the level is at max, even though we don't S clear, you can use SP recovery items to eventually clear the stage, however many more times it takes. So 2 more SP is enough. Okay, so you get to do that a maximum of 3 times per day. So basically my daily routine is, first I do the stages with stamina because that's where I get tickets. I just pick the one that matches the attribute of the tickets that give me the most points, if that makes sense. So something to keep in mind is that it's okay to use the stamina items right away. Like, you can use it all at once on the first day, or that's at least what I do. But for the SP items, you need to kind of like use them sparingly, because you'll need a lot more of the SP recovery items compared to the stamina recovery items. Because essentially you use the SP recovery items twice. Once to level up your final live, and then again to actually do the final live. So in general, I try to keep like at least a total of 5 recovery from whatever combination of SP items I have, just in case. So I got the level up to max again. So we're gonna play another concert. Ooh, I might be able to clear it without- Oh, see. So thanks to the event bonus, even though it looked like I wasn't going to clear at the beginning, it did. Okay, so again, making the level up to max and prioritizing whichever one gives you the most event points. Okay, so last performance of the day. And I try not to overflow on SP. I only use however much I need at the time. This is important so you don't potentially waste any SP. So that's what I do every day. So similar to the main story, after you S-clear everything in the event story, you can read the final pages for more notes. Okay, cut to the future. I got the event SR at 500,000 points. You'll want to immediately power up that card as much as you can because you get an event bonus from it, as you can see from like the little smiley icon. So I gave him all my books. Oh my god. Well, every little power-up counts. Next, I want to put this card on my teams. Also, this is important, about 3 days after an event begins, there's an auto form, but to prioritize maximum event points. I don't know why they gatekeep that after 3 days, but it is what it is. So make sure you do that for every stamina stage and every SP stage of every attribute. Okay, so here we are at the stage to level up our live. Again, I'm doing the auto formation that prioritizes event points. Okay, and the game remembers that I put the event SR on my team, and look at the difference in event points from the first day. Yeah, it makes a big difference. So I'm about halfway, but I see that with my SP recovery, I can still make it. So I go ahead and just do the concert. Remember blue button to continue. Okay, and it needs 5 more. Okay, whew. We just made it. Okay, so again, as you keep playing the event, remember to keep powering up your cards and prioritize the event cards that get the boost. When you're just starting out, I would say you can start using the boost item once you reach level 10 for the final stage. So yeah, turn on that little blazer thing and you'll see that now if I clear it, I get 62k, which, yes, please. Again, I only make it halfway through, but I made sure that I had enough SP recovery items. Yeah, so even though it looked like I would need 6, I cleared it with 5 extra SP. So I've been playing for 10 days, and after 1,100,000 event points, I got the event SSR. Yay! So, again, like we did with the event SR, you power up the event SSR right away. So again, max that card out as much as you can. Now you can prioritize powering up the event SSR over the event SR if you still haven't maxed that one out yet, because it's more powerful, of course. And again, auto-form your team, but the middle button so it prioritizes getting maximum event points. And again, prioritize whichever stage gives you the most event points. So yeah, as you can see, it's even easier to S-clear the final concert. Okay, cut to the future. 1,250,000 points, I got a second copy of the event SR. And whenever you get a second copy of any card, it just automatically blooms. Or idolized, or train, whatever you call it. So I always take that opportunity as a little checkpoint to make sure that I've maxed the event cards as much as I can. And for me personally, in the last days of the event, I try to at least once enjoy the concert of the event song with all the event cards. Because these are original songs that they crank out for all these events. I know the song is like MIDI instruments, it's not like performed by an actual band. But hey, music is music. Mm-hmm. Look at them go. Oh my god, they are so talented. Sometimes there's an event R, but not this time, so when there's not, they give you gacha tickets instead, which is cool. So this is a revival for cards from the first anniversary. I usually get nothing from this. Mitsuyuki. Oh.
Huh?
There's no voice, so it's not an initial. Oh my god. I got the limited first anniversary Mitsuyuki. Damn. Where's his energy for my main account? Okay. This is a revival gacha. Oh, it's cool because you can see what you don't have yet. So this is the trained versus untrained. You get to see the little chibi. Takara Santa doesn't have a beard. And as far as I know, I don't think they get added to the general pool. Because anytime that I've scouted during an event, the only off-rate SSRs I get are initials. Okay, that's more like it. That's more of my luck. This is the general pool, don't ever scout in there. And these are tickets that you get occasionally from login bonuses. This is my main account. I'm also using the event boost, but I still get like the same amount of points. So it's more of a matter of saving stamina and SP because your teams are stronger. So as a beginner, I would say aim to get the event SSR. And as you're a more veteran player, I always try to aim for at least 2 copies, which is pretty doable without putting in too much effort. If you're like more hardcore and you tier, at least the rewards loop at the end. And the rewards are like useful. Okay, so these are the rewards that you can get from doing events. If you get at least 1 event point, you can still get some stuff. Bronze is if you get 1 copy of the event SSR, which is what we did in this tutorial account. What I did for my main is getting 2 copies of the event SSR, and getting gold is 3 copies of the event SSR. The rest you have to fight other people, you have to tier. But the cool part is they show you the current event cutoffs. So if you ever tier, good luck. So we got the goods from getting the bronze placing. These food items are the favorite food of the event cards. So what I do after every event is I make my offering to them. Also, it's important that you do the events because it's a nice way to get a lot of the coins in the board shop. So they got some limited time stuff and they have some permanent decorations for each character. These are items that you put on the side of your board. And this is the background of your board. I'm definitely gonna get something. I'll just go with the classic chalkboard with the instruments. And you can also get the decoration around the border of your board. I'm gonna get the rainbow washi tape looking one. I'm just gonna clear what I have. I'm still gonna use a template, but I'm gonna flex all the achievements that have occurred during this time. I'm gonna put the event SR there. Gonna put the event SSR there. I have to put a title there. I'll put my little bronze title there. Yeah. I'll make this chibi heads of the rest of the event cards. Okay. Another profile thingy. I'll flex my Mitsuyuki. Okay, now we put something on the side. I'll just do the trophy that they give. Okay, change my background. Ooh, okay. A happy pride. Ah, there we go.
Be who you are for your pride.
Okay, much better. And I'll unlock it so people can see it and like it. Okay, and let's change our profile. So, let me change my title to the bronze placing. Yeah. And let me change my second one to my bond with Junta. Yeah. Your titles are public. But the cool thing is the game records every event, when it was, and your placing. So that's really cool. You can see what it looks like to everyone else with that I button. Okay, so I showed you how to start the game. There's just the main story, whenever new chapters come out, and there are events. So I like to think Winbo's is very respectful of my time. And yeah, that's basically it. This video is like almost an hour long, so I'm just gonna end it here. If you have any questions, you can comment literally anytime. I will gladly be of assistance. As a bonus little thank you, I'm gonna give this demonstration tutorial account away to whoever can put in the ID and password first. So there we go. Feel free to add me on Winbo's, not this account, but the one that I'm putting in the description. So thanks again for watching. I'll see you next time and take care.